My name is Jared Ricardo. I'm a PhD student at the University of Western Australia in the Australian Institute of Marine Science. As part of a broader research program on how dredging might affect marine organisms, we're investigating how dredging and its associated sediments might affect critical events like coral reproduction. Most corals reproduce by spawning, where they release their eggs and sperm into the water column where they fertilise. Coral spawning represents a really important time for reefs because it allows them to maintain their populations and also recover following disturbance events like cyclones. Our experimental work was conducted here at the National Sea Simulator, or CSIM. We first designed an experiment to determine whether the sediments were affecting the sperm or the eggs of the coral. We found that while the eggs were still capable of being fertilised with quite high sediment concentrations, far more sperm were required to achieve an adequate level of fertilisation success. Next, we counted the number of sperm in the water surface where the eggs sit, and we found that sperm numbers were actually lower in the presence of sediment. This indicated that the sediment may be stopping the sperm from reaching the egg. The other thing that we discovered was flocks, or small clumps of sediment, developing on the bottom of the fertilisation containers just after we added the sperm. When we looked under the microscope, we saw that particles of sediment were sticking to the sperm, and this was causing them to sink away from the eggs. Corals only have a brief 1 to 2 hour period when sperm and eggs can fertilise before wind and waves spread them apart. Our results suggest that sediments may shrink this already short fertilisation window. This is a problem because many reefs have a spawning event that occurs just a few times a year. These findings are important because future research can now investigate what types of sediment cause the sperm to flock out of suspension and therefore create the greatest risk to coral spawning events. In particular, it's useful for the management of dredging operations where suspended sediments can reach high concentrations and occur over a range of sediment types.